All right, we are back, and we are playing No Man's Sky. We are here. There are bugs on this planet, and I wish for it. I wish for their eggs. You know, that is not the first time that has happened. Also, I have, like, no HP left, but on the plus side, I've got sake. Can I crouch? I don't remember if crouching is an option here. I don't actually have much sake, but I have sake. Let's see. We attempt to escape. Be fine. Hope shields come back soon. Alternatively, flee for ship. Flee for ship. For ship. He's safe here. Okay, he's good. Alright. Let's see. So now that I've modded this, considerably, by the way. I'm not actually sure if I'm going to be able to play this multiplayer at this point, but you know what? It was worth it. Let's see. So we've got a bunch of larval cores. God, this is just going to make life so much easier. Let's see. Oh! Horatian deck police is some of the capital ship. Altorial, are you actually in my session? Can you see if you can join me? Because that would be kind of interesting. Also, the USS Essence of Watermelon. That name is magic. Okay, shield should be back. These guys are still here, though, which is kind of annoying. Okay, do we have... Oh, weapon charge is depleted. Probably fix that. Okay, do we have anything? Yeah, we've got a number of these eggs. I do not know how injured I am. Why can I not? I can interact with some things. My UI is, like, totally off, though, which means either I have no shields or I have every shield. I don't know. Oh, I mean, I have the important parts. Like, how much jetpack I've still got. But this is a bit disconcerting. Ah, ow. Okay, so in fact, they hadn't even hurt me earlier. Perfect. Let's see, your bases were on the planet when I looked, so multiplayer is probably a go. Perfect. Yeah, so for people, I guess, just tuning in, I've modded this game kind of tremendously, so now everything stacks like crazy, which is kind of nice. Let's see. I'm going to wait for my shields to come back a little bit. Wow. That is not nearly as good of a payoff as it sometimes is or normally is or whatever. Whatever. It's fine. Why does this keep happening to me? I don't know. Well, it's okay. It barely does damage to me. In fact, it actually does far less than if they were to hit me conventionally, like that. Okay. Got, like, one more in here. They keep popping me around, but that's not really that big of a deal. Okay. Do we have more? We do have more. Keep that going. Let's see. I'm in... I care mode, I just don't care that much mode. I don't know. Today is a checkout day for me. This week, this month, is... the rest of August is just gonna be, like, me slightly shell-shocked, if only because of the sheer amount of work that I have to get done over the next couple weeks. And I realize I could, like, skip out on a lot of these games, but, like, I don't know. I like covering indie games. I like covering new games. I like covering No Man's Sky, and, like, stopping would be annoying. Stopping would be more inconvenient than slightly overworking myself. Anyway, I think we've got every egg in here, so... snap-a-dap-dap-dap. Let's just hop in the ship. Okay. Hey, thank you, R. Bradshaw, for the 8-month resub. Find your channel while looking for No Man's Sky Let's Plays. I'm glad you're continuing to play through all the updates. I love this game. It's really chill, and it's really fun. It was 12 million. Cripes. Altorial, you gotta clue me in on this. These sweet cashy bits. So where's your watermelon? Is it your ship, or is it your, I'm assuming it's your freighter, right? I'm assuming freighter. Well, do we head for it? Because that's a space station, which I wasn't marked until recently. They add those markers? I don't know. I'm gonna leave it for a second, because I do have... I might as well check this out real quick before I go see what's up with your weird watermelon vehicle. I need more sake. I only poured myself a little bit because it was, like, room temperature. I feel like it would have been better if I had, like, gotten more and then microwaved it or chilled it. I guess we'll find out. It's Choya. I like Choya. It's tasty. Let's see. What this game needs is Subnautica Leviathan creatures. It certainly needs more megafauna. I continuously will demand space whales and stuff. And, like, island turtles that you can put your base on that just kind of wander the world? Like, how rad would that be? Or even, like, moving exo-base situations. Oh, right, I was just here. And I'm a dumbass. Whoops. Let's see if the eggs respawn. Probably not. Seems unlikely. Great job. Perfect parking. Okay. Let's see. Discard the residual goo, as nobody needs. And then we actually have to interact with the thing. Terminal online. Selecting key. Decrypting. Success! The terminal is clogged with an unnerving, pulsating slime. Nevertheless, it appears to function. I really wish they actually made this slime pulsate more often, like, constantly. Ugh. Anyway, nevertheless, it appears to function. As I touch the input panel, the alien substance reacts violently. Make a note to avoid getting closer. The device opens, revealing a single, unblinking crimson eye. It deposits a sample of antimatter accompanied by a strange message. Read the log. You will find us when the time is right. 16, 16, 16, 16, 16. Okay, antimatter housing requires oxygen and ferrite dust. Oh, don't discard the goo, it refines into nanites. Does everything refine into nanites? Because apparently I've been hearing that from, like, everyone. Because apparently these eggs also refine into nanites. Well, I guess I'll just start hoarding shit like crazy and refine it all into nanites, or not ranites. Okay. Where's my ship? My ship is over here. That is a weirdly imperfect parking job, but you know what? I will take it. Alright, Altorial, show me your watermelon. That sounds, I'm gonna say sensual, but it's probably just, I don't know, who cares, doesn't matter. Well, we don't need to know about the galaxy map. We already have that handled. So I have some antimatter. We might as well craft a couple of these. Oh. Well, can't make more, but I can make a warp cell. That was my Harper drive. Question. Warp hypercore. High capacity. Okay, so I need one more for that. Probably need more oxygen, if anything. Yeah, it looks like that's what I'm low on. Alright, I totally forgot about projectile ammunition being a thing in this game. Ah. Let's see. Well. Oh. Well, no, we're getting there. I love the autopilot in this game now. It makes it so much easier to get to places and do things. Alright, so where's this water? Okay. I think I passed you. Show me your watermelon! I wish to know and understand. Tags your capital ship. Huh. Altorial, I have a problem. Namely, it doesn't seem to exist. Well, bonk. I want to just try resummoning it, because that might do the trick. And if that doesn't do the trick, then I don't know. So you land on the planet, you'll resummon. Okay. I'm just gonna go... I'm just gonna go land on your base. See if there's anything I can grab. Wait, oh, that's your other base. Hold on. There's two bases. I've been bamboozled. Let's see. Still no freighter in sight. So yeah, we're just gonna go down. We're just gonna see what we can get. And if it doesn't show up, then so be it. I'm not gonna be that upset. It's gonna be bad if the freighter suddenly loaded in. That would have been fine. Okay. Yeah, it looks like I just can't see your essence of watermelon right now. I don't know if it's the mods, if it's experimental, if it's my game just being broke shit, or what. I don't know. Anyway, I'm just gonna warp out of here. Okay, so galaxy map. Let's see. Huh. So, F4F water, current location. Ah, well, that's a better galaxy map than they had previously. Now, I can't warp to these. Yeah, anomalous signal blocking warp. So my assumption is I can't go to anything that isn't a yellow star. So I guess we're just going to go to Dawataga and just see what we can find there. I definitely like the third-person warp screen. I don't know. They're all good. Okay, Dawataga. What cool mods do you have at your space station? Because that's about the only reason why I care. Also, the anomaly is here. We're going to go to the space station first, then we're going to check out the anomaly. Just because I've heard that the anomaly is kind of crashy. But that might also just be the, like, anomaly hub as opposed to the other stuff. I don't know. One way or another, we'll check it out after we pop off in here for just a moment. The other thing I want to look for is, character mods. It's just going to keep pinging me, isn't it? That's annoying. Am I so poor that I can't afford? Oh boy. I need some cash. Okay, so what does this guy have? So life support. I know I threw away a radiation protection module, in like the very first episode. I just really don't care. I'd rather get shield modules. Doesn't look like they've got any of the S ranks that I'm looking for. Oh good, it's no longer pinging me. Okay, so what does he have? We're looking for Starship. And we don't care about the positron ejector yet. We might. I just mostly want to pick up S rank stuff because the difference is massive. Okay, and that is nowhere close to what I'm using, but that makes sense. At least, again, I haven't fallen out of the world yet, which is a good sign because that sucks. Like, really freaking hard. Let's see, plasma launcher. I want to find some more scanner S modules. Because those are the ones that get ridiculous. Everything less, I don't know, I don't actually know if it's that bad, but still. Okay, so what do we got? Ooh, look at them balls. Okay, exosuits. Install tech. Note to self, give this thing way more tech modules. Anyway, it's only a 30% shield strength bonus. It's not amazing. But if we get into a fight with this thing, it'll probably be a nice change of pace. Okay, so where's this anomaly located? You know, I just got those shields. That might not have been a bad idea. Okay, where is this guy? Here he is. He seems like a relative trash blaster. Wow. This sort of thing was much easier. He's just running away from me at this point. But yeah, this was certainly a lot easier with a controller. That's for sure. Because I don't remember it being that hard. What is the game? Rebel Galaxy Outlaw, which I was playing, what was it, 2 weeks ago? Solid game. Rather enjoyed it. The mouse controls for, like, dogfighting were amazing in comparison. This, not so much, though. The controls are definitely like, oh god, okay, where'd the enemy go? It's really just the lock-on system from Rebel Galaxy that made it so much easier, because you would... If there's an enemy in your sights, you'd kind of snap to them and keep them there. And that felt really, really good. And I'd like to see, I'd like to see more dogfighter games take that approach. I know I could also use a controller, but I don't want to have to, like, switch back and forth between using a controller and keyboard and mouse to play this game. Oh, is this a spaceport? Cool. Don't think I'd actually, like, stick around here just because this planet is full of nothing but weird, like, oh god, it's just like red tentacular testicles just all over the place. It's bad. Likelihood of traveler anomaly now beyond 2 standard deviations. Suggest further aid. Blueprint offered. Unlike other life forms I've met so far, this one speaks in a language I understand, and yet I cannot comprehend their meaning. They speak as if they do not know what they're saying, as if their mind is not their own. The alien offers me a blueprint, a means to construct my own antimatter. Dike. Okay, take the antimatter blueprint. Whoever's leaving this trail has some design. But what it is, I cannot fathom. There's nothing else to do but to continue to follow. Okay, so chromatic metal and condensed carbon. Wow, that is cheap compared to what it used to be. Like, laughably so. Also, this is a sweet-looking ship. Hello, I would like to buy your ship with nothing. I'm so poor. I just want to see if it's any good. It is S-class, and it looks the part. I mean, obviously, it's a lot of generic parts that I've seen before, but it's a good mix. I like my ship, though. Wow, look at that thing. That thing's got wings for days. It looks pretty nice, actually. Now what? I am unsure. So, now what? Okay, so it wants me to do, yep, warp to another system. This is probably fine. Let's see, has Wander tried fossil mining to get credits? Not yet. I'm not sure what I'm gonna do to get credits. Probably farming. Because Well, I don't know. I've got a mod that makes it so they grow faster, so I could go bananas. Just growing like a billion things along the way. Seems like a good idea to me, I don't know. Okay, so what does this rock have? Oh! Starship monitoring system reports error. Guidance system malfunction. Searching for other routes. Searching. Searching. Obtained. Destination in 16 kilo-somethings? Accept new guidance? Accept. Guidance accepted. Plotting route. We have a creepy fuel source. I do love the creepy music that they have play. Whenever you do this. Okay, before we go anywhere though, let's go to the space station. Because I want to grab as many things as I can. Why? Organic entities place monetary value upon individual lives, yes? How much do you value yours? Not. Let us test our hypothesis. All echoes engage. Why? You will not fight me. You get platinum from the crystal asteroids, usually. I remember they used to give more stuff back in the day, and it was kind of exciting to see what you could mine. They standardized it, which is helpful, but also boring. Kilo light years. Ah, that makes sense. Okay, so what do you have? Okay, life support B, movement S, life support S. We don't care about underwater protection. I'd like to get a shield module or two, but this will be fine. Okay. What about this guy? What do you have? Infernife, hyperdrive. I'm gonna run out of nanites this way, but you know what? That's fine. Let's see. Don't Wander's mods work okay if he's on a planet with other people? Yeah, they're actually all client-side and they shouldn't ever interfere with somebody else. We're having trouble seeing Altorial's... let's see. Geology cannon. I'm gonna try it. Oh. I guess I've got to clear inventory out. Okay. Let's see, hyperdrive. Yeah, I gotta get more of these. So, more jetpack tanks, solar panel power, and life support tanks. Yeah, so we're gonna wanna upgrade this so we have more slots there. You also have a hyperdrive module. What does this do? Warp cell fuel efficiency plus 100% and drastically increases the range. Let's see, is there anything else? No, so I just want to buy the thing from him. But yes, this is modded. I'd say it's lightly modded, but mainly it just increases stacks by like a crazy amount. Let's grab the geology cannon one. I'm curious what that'll do. Because I don't remember any of these. And plop that there. This gun is a bit cheesy, but whatever. Oh, the geology cannon is the grenade. It's not the terrain manipulator, it's the grenade attack. Well, I don't have that to begin with, so I guess I'll just leave that in the corner. Ooh, holy crap, look at those engines on the sides. I mean, they're ridiculously overlarge, but they actually do look pretty dang cool. That's fun. I forgot how huge you made the multi-tool. It's a little extensive. Oh. Oh, network's probably disrupted until I actually do plot stuff. Pod racer. I'm actually a little bit disappointed there aren't pod racers in this game, like officially. Okay, that's good enough. Let's head for plot stuff. Okay. Fuel source, they say. It's a trap! It's an absolute. Well, no, it's not. I do hope at some point they actually get to the point where the NPC, like, there are events where NPCs will, like, ambush you and so on and so forth. Maybe. I don't know. I still don't know where they're taking this game, and it would be fascinating to see. There aren't pod racers? No. I mean, there's kind of ships that look pod racery, and there is, like, a hovercraft that you can get, but that's the extent of it. Nothing more. This looks like a nice, cold-ass planet. Whoa! Hi! Okay, this is slightly different from what I was expecting when I flew in here. Okay. Skip that. Wisdom of the Corvax. Bokdim, 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 yun, yun, yun! The stone resonates, and we learn words. A robotic life form turns towards me. Light streams from their metal shell, forming a glowing fog that surrounds us both. They gesture towards me. Accept knowledge. The name Corvax floats in my vision, an echo of the strange vision I just experienced. A word in this alien tongue is seared into my brain. Might actually be a lot of words. Yeah, I modded it so I'd learn a lot of words as I play through this. Because I'm so sick of searching for words. So let us become a polyglot in an accelerated period of time. My brother had a roommate in college who was like a straight up polyglot. The dude could learn words and like whole languages in a month if he wanted to and speak it semi-fluently, and it was insane watching him go. I never met him. I never got to see him that often, but every once in a while I'd be like, how many languages do you know now? And it'd go up by like two. And he was going off to be a translator professionally, so it was kind of cool. Anyway, this structure is unlike anything I've encountered on my journey so far. Everything about it is so obviously alien, so obviously out of place. As I stare at it, words form themselves in my mind, a strange fragment of broken speech. Is it traveler? Is it friend? It is traveler and friend. It feels strange responding to questions I am unsure that I'm being asked, but something has clearly taken notice of my reply. I'm overwhelmed by a sense that something has awoken, that something is watching me. It forms another question. Is it first? Is it last? Last. I do not know how I'm being spoken to. This monolith is ancient, and I cannot escape the feeling it has asked these questions many times over. It asks again. Have they seen the Crimson Eye? Has the Crimson Eye seen them? Both. Likelihood of anomaly exceeds. Safety parameters. Breach detected. Alert. 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 The boundaries fall. The walls collapse. Your universe awaits. Find us, Traveler. Ooh, those look like goodies up there. Yeah, these used to be the money makers when you'd find them. Now I think they're just pretty normal. But it's cool to find a supply all the same. Okay. Grab what I can. Okay, so we've album manned up a little bit. What do we got? It'd be a bad idea for me to get some of the dihydrogen stuff. Definitely got to put together that new computer. This is a little laggier than I was expecting it to be. Eh, screw it. I think that'll be maybe what I consider doing. Okay, do we go check out that? We might as well. Might as well check out the freighter. I still think it would be really rad if you could actually find one of these freighters and fix it up. This is kind of like a cool feature of, like, lifting it from the surface and getting it up into space. And, you know, keeping it for yourself, kind of. Even if it has, like, a hefty resource cost to actually fix it up. Log extraction complete. Read log. Life goes on, day after day, delivering I hope to go home soon. The life of a is not for one like me. Wait, we've already read this. That's a bit of a shame. Okay, I'm actually gonna switch to my controller. My wrist hurts. If I can get my controller to actually function here. Options, control options. Maybe. Nope, doesn't look like it's gonna work. Well, that's unfortunate. Okay, so let's check these out. So there's a good reason to salvage these now. They give you blueprints to boost your own freighter. That's cool. Okay. Grab that. Admittedly, Starship launch fuel is not that useful. I wonder if I have to have my own freighter before I can start getting these blueprints. I'm betting that's actually super likely. Oh. It might be more than that. At least I got a fuel cell out of it, so I guess I'll call that a win. Let's see. Well, summon vehicles, summon ship. That is so handy. I love it. Last one gives you a blueprint. Oh, is there another one? Because I've only ever seen two in these. Oh, there's usually around six. It's a magnetized ferrite deposit. Cargo pod. Okay, good to know. Let's see, once you get the launch thruster, you don't need fuel anymore. It's so nice. Okay. Eh. Aw. That's confusing. Okay. We got another cargo pod there. Yeah, I guess they are a little bit more prevalent than I thought. On the log, there will be a quest telling you how many are left. Cool. I guess I will pay more attention to these then. Well, for starters, we should probably go back to my exosuit and transfer some of this stuff. What do you mean out of range? Like, literally right there. It even has the receiver thing. Okay, I'm gonna move over the salvage data. Carbon nanotubes, these. Definitely the nav data. Probably the albumin pearls. Anything else? I don't know. I've still gotta increase my inventory as much as possible. This is cool. Hard to get around, though. Okay. I'm just gonna make myself some space. Okay, so that's how I get out. Here's the entrance. Well, that's... I mean, that's not actually that much money in the grand scheme of things, but it feels like a lot. So I will be glad that I got it. Okay. Oh, I see. Where's the entrance to this sucker? Here? No. There we go. I'm gonna get irradiated so hard. Well. Radiation leak detected. New item recorded. Unstable gel. Okay. See, wonder if you ever got the chance to combine two games, what would they be? Hmm. I don't freaking know. That's a hard one to answer, too. I mean, I've definitely talked about this before, but if it was only one, I don't know. Did I get that? I did. It's weird. Like, half the time I get the thing out of it before I even, like, repair, which is confusing and strange. Persona and Monster Hunter. Huh. Warframe and Monster Hunter. Honestly, would end up playing something like a really, really good version of Remnant from the Ashes. I think that would be it for me. Minecraft and Warframe. Nah. I mean, kinda. It would be cool to have like a true blue open universe I mean, honestly, this plus Warframe would actually be an amazing combination as well. Okay, so we got polyfiber and some other things. Question. If we go log? Well, we don't have a secondary mission, so... I'm assuming we're good. Did they ever turn down the Sentinels? It feels like it was easier to get swarmed before. Yeah, they turned it down considerably, honestly. Let's see, so anything in Warframe? Yeah, probably. Warframe is just like, the core gameplay loop for that game gets repetitive, but boy is it high quality. Incoming transmission. Source unknown. You are not alone. Please, identify yourself. Identify yourself. You left me. Why did you... Tell them you are sorry. Don't lie to me. You... Even the others did not. Ask about the others. There's no reply. The communicator falls silent, though the channel remains open. Creepy. Space bits. There's some freighters over there that I cannot afford. There we go. That's where it is. Oop. And this, I believe, is just a communicator. I don't know if I'm gonna finish the story this time around for No Man's Sky. I might not. I've never done it. I usually fall off after a certain point because it's just kind of fiddly and like fly from place to place, just talking to people and occasionally interacting with something. And it's interesting, but it's definitely one of those where it's like, it's easy to just be like, eh, I'll do it later. Let's do sandbox stuff. And then I just don't. Maybe we'll just make a night of it at some point and just go like real hard. The story doesn't actually end fully, at least. But yeah, no, that's fair.